Hello everybody, I'm Errichto and this is Merging Two Sorted Lists, a coding interview question recently often asked by Amazon. The statement is quite simple. We are given two sorted lists, like those you're seeing right now on the screen, and we need to combine them, create one big sorted list, and return the head to that sorted list. Before solving this problem, let's first talk about terms and words used for linked lists. The beginning of a list is called head, the end is tail. Every single thing in the list is node, and node is described by two values. Its value, maybe for example 7, and a pointer to the next node. If it was double linked list, then there would also be pointer to the previous node. But in this problem we deal with a single linked list. In this problem, which by the way you can solve on LeetCode, what we will be given is head to one list, head to the other list, and from this we need to create a big list and return head to that one. But let's remember some limitations of a list. For example, given this head of a list, you don't know size of a list. If you want to get to a tail, or get ith node, or get the size, you need to follow pointers to the next one, and eventually tail has pointer to null value. Its pointer is set as null, and then you know this is the last node in a list. This code below is a definition for a node of a list. It has indeed int value, pointer to the next node in a list, and some constructor, so you could create a new node if you need to. Now we are ready to solve a problem. Given pointers to head of the first list and head of the second list, let's say L1 and L2, we can easily find the first node in sorted combined list, because it will be smaller of those two. Here, 2 is smaller than 3, so for sure this will be head of the combined list. After we add it in some way to a combined list, we should move L1 pointer to the next node, and now we decide about L2 versus L1. L2 is smaller value, so I will append node with value 3 to the end of combined list being created, and now L2 moves to the next node. Thanks to the fact that both lists are sorted, every time the next node I want to add to the combined list, it will be first node in first list or first node in the second list. I need to just compare those two values. In general, this is called two pointers technique, and let's take a look at its more common use case, merging two arrays. This is part of the very important algorithm, merge sort, which is arguably the easiest n-log-n sorting algorithm. There are two main ways to implement merging two sorted arrays, here in C++. In both methods, we start from the beginning of the first array, let's say index I, and the beginning of the second array, index j. There will be initially equal to 0. I want to every time compare those two values and move I or j by 1 to the right. If ai is smaller than b of j, then move I to I plus 1, and this 4 appends to the combined array. Then compare b of j with new a of I, maybe here it will be 7. 7 is bigger, so smaller value is 6. I need to take 6 to the combined array and move j to the right by 1. There are two ways to decide the moment when we stop this algorithm, and they lead to two different implementations. In both methods, I have an array or vector answer, and to that one I append new values 4, 6, then maybe 7, and say 9, 8. It would be 7. 8, and so on. Method number 1 is on the left. We create I and j equal to 0, and while at least one of those indices is still within the boundaries of its array, we continue. Maybe one of them is already outside of the array. For example, j is equal to b.size. If j is here and I is still there, we run out already of elements of the second array, then we want to continue adding elements of the first array. Hence, a complicated if here. When do I want to add ai to the answer? Either if j is equal b-size, if I'm already out of the second array, or in the other case, if j is still somewhere within the boundaries, if I is also in the boundaries, it's here, and ai is smaller than bj, then take a of I and increase I by 1. I plus plus here will be run after a of I is pushed back to the end of answer. In the opposite case, we need b of j and increase j by 1. The implementation is quite short, but an if is complicated. The alternative is on the right. We continue the while loop only while both indices I and j are within their arrays. Then we just compare a of I with b of j. And after that, still there's some part of one of the arrays left. And I need to handle that separately. While I is smaller than A size, take all remaining elements of array A, and the same with B. Exactly one of those two parts will happen, but still I need to implement both. I prefer the left version because it's shorter, but it isn't necessarily better for the problem about merging two sorted lists. We could obviously iterate both those lists, create arrays out of them, then merge two sorted arrays and create a new combined list out of that, but for sure it will not be efficient. In particular, the space complexity is linear. While instead we can just modify pointers in the two given sorted lists and not create any new memory. But why the implementation on the right is better for lists? Let's analyze what happens when we run out of one list. There is L1, L2, L1 is a smaller value, so I move it to the right, I add 8 to a sorted list. Now L1 will be null. What happens in code is L1 becomes L1.next. And you could say that now what's left is to iterate over the second list and add each of those elements. But for a list, we don't have to do it. If this was the last element so far, it's enough to say that after that, the next one is 9. So we rewire a pointer from 8 to 9. This one will already be destroyed. The new combined list will be something like this. And 9 already points to 12. Maybe after 12 there is something more to the right. Maybe there are 1,000 more elements. Maybe 1 billion. We don't need to iterate all of those. Pointers are already set correctly. Values are already set correctly. We can just return our list and it is done. The difference between two implementations in sorted lists problem would be that left implementation does some unnecessary work, iterating through the end of one of those two sorted lists after the other one is already done, while on the right we could replace those with just a single operation each, change a single pointer and that's it. The implementation will roughly be this. Compare the first element of first list and the second one. Here, first is smaller, so I will say this is the beginning, the head, of the whole list. Move pointer L1 to the next node in the first list. Here there will be value 5, but we don't know that yet. L1 is moved to the right. This will remember as the start of everything. We need to return from a function pointer to the beginning of a list, to head, and we will return that pointer start. We need to remember it. Then we compare L2 with L1 again. There will be 5 here, so we move L2 to the next node, but we obviously need to create a new combined list. After start, after node with value 2, there should be 3. I will change this pointer into the one pointing to 3. And then, so far the list is 2 into 3. Then 4 is smaller than 5, so I will move L2 to be more on the right. After 3, there should be pointer to 4. So this one doesn't change, but in general, I need to remember the last so far element of my combined list. Then last will change into this one. And the main while loop will be, while we are not out of the lists, change a pointer of last to the next smaller element and move L1 or L2. There can be ties, by the way, there is tie between 5 and 5, and then it doesn't matter how we decide it. The combined list can be 4, 5, 5, or it can be 4, 5, 5. The values will match. Finally, implementation. We need to create start. There will also be last, the last node in combined list, so we would know what next pointer we should change. Compare first values of both lists. If L1 is smaller, then start is L1. L1 becomes L1 next, else the opposite. And initially last is exactly start. The first and last node in combined list is just the same node, because the list size is 1. Even before the main algorithm, our implementation is already several lines. You can make a mistake here. And actually this is not correct, because L1 or L2 can represent empty lists, then it will be null. And here we have runtime error. You cannot check val of something that is not null pointer. I should here add if L1 is equal null, then just return L2. And if L2 is null, return L1. But this seems overcomplicated, and there is a way to improve this. In problems about linked lists, always consider creating a fake vertex or a dummy vertex. We'll put it here and we'll say it has value minus 1, whatever, it doesn't really matter. And instead of making extra ifs at the beginning, if L1 has smaller value in the first position, then we start from that one, or there is the other one. You just say that that minus 1 is starting vertex, and you already start the while loop that will combine between L1 and L2. Start will get a pointer to this vertex, then this one to F3, and so on. And at the end, we'll get big combined list with one unnecessary vertex. So instead of returning start, I will return next of start. Start points to the beginning of real combined list, and I should return that. Remember, always consider creating fake vertex. If, let's say, value minus 1, I will not compare it with anything. It could have value 100, and actually I will leave 100 here, but you should better put here 0 or minus 1. It's more meaningful. But to show you it doesn't matter, I will leave 100. I use a constructor. They allowed me to create a new node. I don't need start now. And last is initially pointer to fake, and remove all of that. This is how much you gain thanks to creating a fake node. We are using that implementation from the right part. While both pointers are within their lists, while L1 is not null and L2 is not null, this is how you check if it's a real node. If first value is smaller than the second value, then I need the next node from the first list. Last next is L1. This is needed so we would create the big combined list. L1 is L1 next. And last vertex of the whole combined list is now L1. No, it is L1 before the change. If I notice that I need to add 5, I say for the last vertex, you should now point to this 5. Now 5 is the last vertex. And move L1 so you would keep combining two lines, two lists, else the opposite. By the way, we can put here smaller than or equal to. It will be fine. It's just about deciding ties. This is symmetrical to that thing. We can still be inside one of lists. So if L1 is not null, I want to add this node. Last next is L1. And the cool thing is I don't need any of that. This could theoretically be those three lines, but I don't need them. I will not continue doing anything more. I'm just saying if L2 is not null, do the same. Both those things are impossible at the same time, because if they are both true, then while loop would continue. Last next is L2. This is enough to append something to a list we are creating, and return fake.next. Fake has some value that doesn't matter, here 100, but we never compare the value in last with something else. We just compare two new values. And fake.next is that first element of the real thing. I should have first run code, but I submitted it, it's okay. The only thing I would do differently during a real coding interview is here put minus 1 or 0. 100 seems too arbitrary. Time complexity of this solution is O of n plus m, where n, m are sizes of two lists. It doesn't help us for complexity that we finish here earlier if we run out of one list, because pessimistically we will get to almost the end of both lists. And space is constant, O of 1, because we only create fake and pointer last, and that's it. Learning solution to a single problem will not land you a job in Google or Amazon, but solving 100 problems will for sure increase your chances. This is why I'm advertising algoexpert.io. It's a platform with currently 85 problems. You can implement those, submit just like in LeetCode, but for each problem there is also video tutorial and detailed code walkthrough, so you will understand the details better and you will actually see how to implement that. I watched some of the videos in x2 speed, including the hardest one, I think airport connections, and I was surprised how intuitive it was. Even though the problem was hard and formal proof would take a lot of time, they are able to tell you some intuition behind solving a problem, and I appreciate that. There's also now system design section, so the whole package will prepare you for coding interviews even better. So consider algoexpert.io and use code Errichto, or just click link in the description, for a discount. Implementation of my solution to merging two sorted lists is in my GitHub repository, but of course it's better if you just go to that problem in LeetCode and try to solve it yourself to make sure you can do it now on your own. Hope you enjoyed the video. Bye!